they have to show, and usually they have to put skin in the game. In other words, the business has to say, we anticipate, you know, X number of jobs or economic growth, so the state's getting a return on that tax exception or exemption. We do that for incentive programs too. In other words, we say there's a grant program or a governor's opportunity fund. They have to say, within 5 years, we're going to create 100 jobs or whatever. And it's weighted based on the amount they receive, is weighted on what economic activity they're going to have in the state. Local people do that sometimes too. They have more limited resources, obviously. But they are specific study looking at all these exemptions. We've got tons of them. And I'm actually going to have a deal. I'm still looking through the study to do away with a bunch of them that no longer are effective or not serving the purpose. In fact, one of them I introduced a few years ago that's not working. That is to try to get you all to buy long-term care insurance. There was a tax exemption. Well, most people aren't taking advantage of it. So it makes no sense to keep that on the books if it's not serving the purpose, even though it was a good intended. The purpose is by encouraging people to take care of themselves, you know, later in life. So we may, you know, take that off and maybe look at some other ways that we can try to encourage people to do that.
We haven't been able to get that through either the House or the Senate. But hopefully we'll be able to get some momentum this time around. And maybe we can just wipe the slate clean. That'd be my.
Well, if you did that, you'd have to do away with all the exemptions. Now, we had, because that would be fair. I mean, if we're going to do away with the corporate income tax, then take away all their special exemptions that they have. The problem is, the last time we tried to do that in 2004, rather than do a tax increase, which was finally, I didn't vote for it, but it was finally a compromise. We actually tried to put through a bill to do away with all the exemptions for a number of businesses that, again, had these exemptions year after year after year. And you never saw so many paid lobbyists that had $5,000 suits and, you know, outfits all of a sudden show up in Richmond because all those corporations like that special exemption they have. But that's the debate we're having that we're going to look at. But I agree with Ben, if we're going to do it, we need to do it in a fair way so that. I mean, you can't have your cake and eat too. Either do away with the corporate income tax or do away with the exemption. That'd be the fairest way to do it.
Or at least start sunsetting, and requiring them to justify their risk.
Yeah.
Come before us every year and justify their risk. That's what I'd like to do with budget process. I mean, get everybody who gets funded through the budget, that's some zero-based budget is a great idea. But make them all come into the Appropriations and Finance Committee and justify their existence to these guys every year. And that takes a little more time.
I don't want to be a full-time budget.
I don't either. But these guys are the kind of guys who would look carefully and make sure that they are spending every penny wisely.
I think the best tax policy, the most policy we have in Virginia, is tax policy that's fair and the way you can make sure revenue rather than paying. You know, you